inside Cavanaugh Hall here on the campus of IUPUI for Jag Sports Zone, where we bring you everything Jags athletics. I'm your host, Tyler Locke. On today's show, we'll show highlights from the week that was, head over to the soccer field to meet one of our athletes, and give you a heads up on what you can look forward to this week. In the week that was, we start with the IUPUI swimming and diving teams, who finished their regular season on January 31st against Xavier. The Jags handily defended the IU Natatorium, winning almost every event ahead of the Horizon Championships, taking place February 19th through the 22nd. The IUPUI divers each had one of the best nights of the season, with senior Patrick Tenner seen here on the 3-meter, setting a school record on the 1-meter springboard. Tenner scored 371.9 points, besting the 17-year-old record of 335.33. In women's competition, both Carolyn Dietz and Riley Dalham earned scores on the 1-meter that qualified for the NCAA Zone Championships. The IUPUI men beat the Musketeers 192.5 to 82.5, and the women won 175 to 99. Good luck to the Jags as they prepare for conference. Our men's tennis team had its home opener and welcoming the University of Indianapolis into the West Indy Racquet Club this past week. The Greyhounds brought their A game, but Sean Bailey and Ethan Mardeda's Budiono were ready to meet the challenge. Thought this was pretty cool, the team getting fired up before the first serve. Look at them right there. To begin the match, Budiono with a beautiful return. This was a sign of things to come in this matchup. UND struggled, but the point here is made off the net, and you can see Bailey's frustration as he walked away a little bit too soon. Later, Bailey returns a ball that knocks UND's Tom Zook off balance. Finally, the two sides trade returns before another beautiful strike by Bailey, and they take the game 6-4 at the number two. Ultimately, the Jags would fall on their home opener 5-2. The men's tennis team was in Madison taking on the Badgers of Wisconsin, and unfortunately, the team dropped the match 7-0. Our women's tennis team also faced UND for their match against the Greyhounds. The team has played strong all season and needed to be on their very best against this team. Samantha Hayward was just that in her singles matchup against Maria Solin Skina. At the beginning of the match, the return cannot be served as Hayward takes the point. Later in the first set, the return is fierce as Hayward increases her lead. The two trade returns until the ball lands out. One more out here to end it. This one was close, but Hayward takes the match in three sets. Ultimately though, the Jags would fall 6-1. It was the third annual Readers or Leaders game at the Farmers Coliseum. The Jags welcome in the Phoenix of Green Bay as they look to get an early afternoon win. For the Jags, it was Jalen Minette and Marcus Burke. Incredible off-balance three by Minette right here. He had it going all night long, dropping 32 points on 8 threes. In this game, he went over the 1,000-point career mark, the 24th in school history to do so. But unfortunately, when it came to Green Bay, it rained, it poured. Minette did what he could, but it wasn't enough. Green Bay, they only hit 9 threes in this game, but all of them came in about a 5 to 6 minute spurt that put us behind. We had a strong showing in the second half, but couldn't complete the comeback as we fall 91-85. The Jags were a little unmanned when the men's basketball team traveled to Youngstown State for a conference clash. Only 7 players saw action and every single one were needed to get through this game. Marcus Burke had 22 and Grant Weatherford had 19, but strong scoring from Youngstown State was the downfall as they win 91-76. 9 W's and counting. That was where the girls' basketball team stood as they stayed in the jungle to welcome in Youngstown State. 4 players in double figures and 50% shooting from the field was the key as these Jags improved to 16-6 with a now 10-game winning streak. It was a late one for the Lady Jags when they traveled to Detroit Mercy to take on the Titans. Currently on a 10-game win streak, you know we would love for them to push it to 11. Macy Williams had 23 and Rachel McLemore had 21 as our Jags dominated. They picked up their 11th straight win, 95. There is always a lot going on. We're going to take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, we're going to take a look at how another star athlete not just joined a team, but made an entire family with it. We'll be right back after this.
Hey! It's always out there. The horizon. A reminder that our greatest goals are rarely attained. And as soon as you reach one, another emerges. But every day we rise and work harder, dig deeper, ask one more question, take one more shot in relentless pursuit of our horizon.
Welcome back, everybody. Put yourself in this situation. You're 17 or 18 years old and you're thinking about that next chapter in your life. You begin to formalize what your goals are and what you're willing to do to reach them. What would you do though? Move out of your hometown, region, state? What about the country? Start over anew in a place you've never been before? That's exactly what Valentine Percy did. And we discussed that in this week's Athlete Profile.
Before I got recruited, I had been to the US zero times. I'd never been to any part of the US. I mean, I've been around Europe, but then I started talking to colleges and my dad and my mom were like, we have to go over there before you commit. Otherwise, I think it'd be going into the unknown. So in April, I'm pretty sure it was a March, I came over and I visited IUPUI and then I went to one other place. And then after that, I went back home and committed. And then the second time I came to the US was when I moved to live here, so.
I'm Valentine Percy, I'm a junior on the women's soccer team. I play attacking midfield at IUPUI.
I live an hour and a half southeast of London in a place in a little village called Ticehurst. I live just off the reservoir in a kind of English cottage, basically. I started playing soccer because my brother did when he was a few years older than me. I kind of saw him going out playing and kind of having fun, and I wanted to have fun as well, so I went along with him when he was practicing, and then I joined the same club team as him, which is called Jarvis Brook, and played there from 4 to 9, 10 years old. UI basically was kind of the not so big city to choose from, but basically a small town that I could go downtown, visit, do things with my friends, and also the team gave me a family sort of feel. They straight away were cracking jokes with me, and I was scared that they wouldn't get my sarcasm, but thankfully they did, because that's pretty much my humor, so that's why I chose IUPUI. Academics for me when I was growing up weren't always, like, I wasn't always I need A's, otherwise I can't go through the next day, but it's once I joined IUPUI and I was surrounded by people who are focused on maintaining that high GPA. I'd never been around a GPA sort of system before, so it definitely became, like I spoke about earlier, my competitive side came out, and I found myself, I'd get a C or a B in a class and I would not be happy, so academics has definitely become a huge part of my day-to-day, and I want to do well and I want to achieve a high grade compared to my roommates and my friends, because they're all some of the smartest people I've ever been around. I kind of would advise to stick to a routine. If you know that you perform well once you've got all your homework out of the way and you've done your studies before the game, then focus on getting it done before and then you can focus on the game. For me, that was definitely something that I wanted to do, so I did my studies as early as possible so I could get out of the way and focus on that big game or that big practice that I had to prepare for. I would say the most rewarding part about being a student athlete is definitely the friendships you create from being on a team. I've always been on a team and I've always cherished the relationships I create, and I know that my best friends will be from this team for years to come. I definitely will never forget winning a championship with the team I came in as a freshman, and I hope to win as a senior as well, so I'll never forget those memories too.
Thank you so much to V for meeting with us. We're going to take a quick break, but when we return, we'll give a preview of what's to come. We'll be right back.
Indianapolis, the heart of hoops hysteria. And beginning in March, the home of the Horizon League Men's and Women's Basketball Championships.
eight teams look to reach the horizon and punch their ticket to the NCAA tournament at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum. Semifinal action takes place Monday, March 9th, and Horizon League champions are crowned Tuesday, March 10th. Visit HorizonLeague.com for more information and to score your tickets today.
Welcome back to the Jag Sports Zone. Our Geico Careers Performers of the Week are Macy Williams from the women's basketball team, Aubrey Wing from women's swimming. Men's swimming has two athletes, Sam Hawes and Patrick Tenner. Ethan Mardanis Budiono from men's tennis and Grant Weatherford from men's basketball are our performers of the week. The women's golf team are in action today in the Motor City Cup. It is being held in Howley Hills, Florida at the Mission Inn Resort. Wishing all our Jags the best of luck. The men's tennis team is back in action Wednesday the 12th as they welcome Xavier into the West Indy Racquet Club at noon. They then have a quick turnaround as they travel to Dayton to take on the Flyers at 7 p.m. on Friday the 14th. They finish up Sunday the 16th as they welcome in Marquette at 10 a.m. The women's basketball team look to keep their streak going as they travel to Wright State on Thursday the 13th at 7 p.m. That game can be streamed at ESPN+. They turn around and travel to Highland Heights, Kentucky to take on Northern Kentucky in a conference clash. The game begins at 2 p.m. on Saturday the 15th and can be streamed on ESPN3. The men and women track team travel to Grand Valley State on the 14th and 15th for the Grand Valley State University Big Meet. It takes place in Allendale, Michigan and starts at 10 a.m. If you want to catch them closer to home, the women also have a presence in Bloomington on the 14th and members of the men's team will be at DePaul on the 15th. The men's golf team will travel to Savannah, Georgia on the weekend of the 15th for the Invitational at Savannah Harbor. And finally, the women's tennis team goes to Nashville, Tennessee to take on Tennessee State at 10 a.m. on the 16th of February. We thank you all once again for tuning in for this week's edition of Jag Sports Zone. Make sure you check out all the upcoming Jaguars action. This is Tyler Locke signing off until next week. Take care and remember, go Jags.